Senator Cornyn is a member of the Senate Judiciary Committee. He's by telephone today back in Austin, Texas. Senator, good morning to you.
Good morning, Bill.
Your reaction to this pick?
Well, Mike, congratulations to Judge Sotomayor for her nomination, and the president now has done his job, which is to nominate somebody to the Supreme Court. Now, of course, it's the Senate's constitutional responsibility to evaluate her record, her background, her experience, and also, I think the point that most of us will be focusing on is her judicial philosophy, whether it's true she does believe that judges on the Supreme Court are supposed to make policy, or whether they see themselves more in the Chief Justice John Roberts mode of calling balls and strikes.
Yeah, what is your first question, Senator?
Well, I'd like to ask her about that comment where she said the courts of appeals, the court on which she served now for a number of years in New York, whether she really believes that courts should make policy, or whether policy should be made by the elected branches of government, because, of course, the electorate reserves the right to throw the rascals out if they don't like what kind of policy is being made. But on the court, they're given lifetime tenure, and there is no similar way to change the direction of that policy making.
Yeah. Have you ever met her, Senator?
I have not. I'll certainly look forward to doing that soon.
Yeah, Michael Steele is among a number of people putting out statements right after the announcement was given in the East Room of the White House. He says there must be a thorough and thoughtful examination of her legal views. I hear you saying a similar thing.
That's true.
Well, what Tim O'Brien was referring to is the initial statement by the president, and her introduction may go a long way to disarm the critics. Do you believe that?
Well, she certainly has a compelling personal story, and you know, anyone, to me, it just says something about the greatness of America, where somebody from such humble beginnings can persevere and overcome and rise to the very top of the legal profession. I congratulate her for that. The question now, though, is whether she possesses not only the experience but the qualifications, including the judicial temperament, to recognize that a judge's role in our government is not primarily as another branch of the legislature making policy, but whether she understands that the role of the Supreme Court is to interpret the law as handed down by the elected representatives of the people.
Now, you go back 21 years in the Clarence Thomas and Anita Hill hearings that really captured a nation, quite frankly. And since that time, every nominee that's gone before that committee on Capitol Hill has drawn enormous attention from everyone across the country. Now, some of those have been filled, frankly, with more drama than others. What is your anticipation for the amount of drama that may face her?
Certainly there'll be a lot of attention because of the importance of this appointment, because of her compelling personal story that we've been talking about, and her record of accomplishment as a judge. But being on the federal district court, as she was appointed by George Herbert Walker Bush in 1992, and being appointed to the Court of Appeals, as she was by President Bill Clinton, are entirely different jobs than being appointed to the United States Supreme Court.
So the fact that the first President Bush nominated her has no significance today?
Totally different role. And I think what the Senate's going to have to do is to take our time. The American Bar Association is going to have to do its background investigation. The FBI is going to have to do its job. And then we'll have to have a hearing where we get a chance to ask her the types of questions that you might expect that cover some of the ground we've discussed this morning.
All right, Senator, thank you. Look forward to seeing you again in person real soon, okay? Senator John Cornyn by telephone there in Austin, Texas. It is now official. It is now history as far as